It's Mango Valeri.
And Mango Asta.
And today we are here to review a 2016 hit,
a must watch, Dear Zindagi, directed by Gauri Shinde.
The movie has a basic idea. We all need to accept and understand. जब हम अपने आप को अच्छी तरह से समझ लेते हैं तो दूसरे हमारे बारे में क्या सोचते हैं, हमें क्या समझते हैं, it doesn't matter, not at all.
It also talks about the taboo in India. Seeking professional help for mental health is necessary.
Also, there are many hidden messages. Like Indians की सोच की वजह से हमारे इंडिया का एटमॉस्फेयर ऐसा हो गया है that people of LGBT community have to go to a दिमाग का डॉक्टर to accept their own self.
It also showcases how female have capabilities to shoot a film, flying airplane, but the fight starts with fighting the mentality of their own parents and society, who doesn't even give a house to an independent woman, even in urban cities.
बचपन में जब रोना आता है तो बड़े कहते हैं आंसू पूछो, जब गुस्सा आता है तो बड़े कहते हैं गिव्स अ स्माइल, ताकि घर की शांति बनी रहे. नफरत करना चाहते हैं तो इजाजत नहीं थी, तब जब हम प्यार करना चाहते हैं तो पता चलता है ये सारा इमोशनल सिस्टम ही गड़बड़ा गया, काम नहीं कर रहा, कैन नॉट फंक्शन. रोना, गुस्सा, नफरत, कुछ भी खुलकर एक्सप्रेस नहीं करने दिया.
Movie briefly explains the relationship that youngsters encounter in a cosmopolitan urban areas and how that affects them mentally and emotionally.
The leading character Kyra has been through not so attached parenting in her childhood, which leads to her adulthood anxieties.
There was a scene wherein we get to know that Kyra was abandoned by her parents in her childhood, but then they took her back. No, not out of love. But they took her back because they got to know that their child failed the third standard. So, out of shame.
To that, their relative exclaimed, "See, beta, third standard ke baad toh kabhi fail nahi hui na."
Which explains that some people never change. They never try to see and understand other person's perspective, and they never understand other person's feeling. They stick to their opinion, which sometimes becomes difficult for an individual to fight.
This turns out Kyra to be depressed, damaged, insomniac, who finds solace in her some friends, spicy food and unnecessary shopping.
There was also a hidden message for young parents.
You do see. So let's get to the first half, which leaves us in a question mark that why Kyra didn't sit the restaurant guy? Why she didn't show her feelings to Raghavendra? Why she does not agree on her attraction? Why is she acting so weird?
By intermission, Kyra goes on a family duty to Goa. वो कहते हैं ना, ज़िंदगी में जब भी कोई pattern बनता या कोई आदत बनती दिखाई दे ना, तो उसके बारे में अच्छी तरह से सोच लेना चाहिए. Genius is knowing about when to stop.
Exactly. And there she meets Dr. Jahangir Khan, which is skillfully played by Shah Rukh Khan. Enters like a beam of light in a dark room.
Dr. Jahangir Khan is a psychiatrist, frank, accepting, charming, exceptionally acute, just like a divine relief to Kyra's life and the movie.
Therefore, in the interactive sessions with Dr. Jahangir Khan, Kyra consults him addressing her life story with someone else and ended up accepting it to be her story.
To that, Dr. Jahangir told an inspiring story about mountainous, which left us with the learning that people purposefully choose hard path to get success. But sometimes the easy path is the correct direction to the life and success.
Movie would have been a failure without Kyra, but I agree. Her realistic and convincing acting made the movie stand. She is the pulse of the movie.
Also, Shah Rukh Khan is a lot more as an actor than his famous pose, clearly seen in this movie, and his role as Dr. Jahangir Khan. He was so peculiar in his acting that the movie went so good.
Let's go to the supporting characters and actors.
The three boyfriends of Kyra, extremely good looking, and they fit perfectly to their role.
Let's get it with a quote. हम इतनी कुर्सियां देखते हैं एक खरीदने से पहले, फिर अपना लाइफ पार्टनर चूज करने से पहले ऑप्शंस देखने में क्या प्रॉब्लम है?
this message wouldn't have been conveyed by the film without that presence.
Her brother, Kiddo, played by Rohit Saraf, had a cute little role, but a very supporting as well. But her parents gave a balancing positive and negative role to the film.
And oh my god, she had such adorable and supporting friends named Jackie and Fatty, played by Yashaswini Dhanama and Ira Dubey. Everyone should have a piece of them in their life.
The movie has a lot of iconic dialogues. Let's start with one.
Har tooti hui cheez chori ja sakti hai.
Hum apni zindagi ka steering wheel apne haath mein nahi lenge, to koi dusra driver seat par baith jayega.
तुम अगर खुल के रो नहीं पाओगे तो हंस कैसे पाओगे?
And definitely a lot more. Let's go to the direction part, which was good.
Visual appeal 10/10.
Costume 10/10.
Music by Amit Trivedi, Arijit Singh, Sunidhi Chauhan, Vishal Dadlani and Jasleen Royal. They all gave a cool melodious touch throughout the movie.
Let's come to an end. We give this movie a 4.5 star out of 5. We cut the half point as per the unrealistic presence of the counseling sessions shown in this movie.
William Faulkner once said, "The past is never dead. In fact, it's not even the past."
We also hope that you like our video.
So do like, share and subscribe.
Thank you.